Midway in the Apollo program, I had met Jack. He was one of the astronauts, but he was the only scientist, so most of the astronauts were engineers or pilots. During Apollo 17, when he was on the moon, he was just so enthusiastic that we couldn't keep him from falling down. At 1/6 G, it's hard to walk, and he kept falling down, and he had this Hasselblad camera attached to his chest of his suit, and he kept falling on it, falling on it.
I was in the process of training for the Apollo 17 mission, and Dr. Taylor was working with the group that was going to do the lunar sample analyses.
During Apollo 17, when he was on the moon, it was a bunch of scientists in the back room at Johnson Space Center, and we were advising him to what to do. You know, now we didn't have to do that much because Jack was so enthusiastic. Being a geologist, he knew more than most of us in the room did.
I've worked with Professor Larry Taylor for many years and others here at the University of Tennessee. It has been a very fruitful and productive association.
December 12, 1972 is the last time a person was on the moon. That is a long time. And when these kids I stopped to talk about, and I said, do you know when Apollo was, when the last person on the moon? It was before any of them were born. But to talk to a person who's actually, you know, it's Buck Rogers. It's all the things of fantasy world. We've had a long history, and I have them here every few years to stimulate the students. The enthusiasm that he brings to me, he also instills in the students and the other faculty. That's why he's here. I was invited to come here in 1973, and we now have seven people in our Planetary Geosciences Institute, and they all work on getting money from NASA. All along, I've talked to Jack back and forth about things. He's given me insight into certain programs that I didn't know about that I might go after.
I was strolling on the moon one day.
And last night, for hours, we were reminiscing. And I said to Jack, I said, Jack, you know, you've always been my hero. He said, oh, come on now. You know, and so Jack, you know, tells everybody how good I am. And I, you know, it's sort of nice. He's being very nice to me. But he is such a super scientist, such a great person.